The fight between Ram and Ravana is celebrated every year at Dashehra, the festival of Vijayadashmi, in every city in India. Valmiki described this fight in glowing words. This chapter is a great literature in its own right in the Valmiki Ramayana. Writes Valmiki, Ravana entered the battlefield in a new chariot pulled by horses covered with diamond studded harness and garlands of gold. It was loaded with weapons that could kill an entire army. Rama noticed the black horses pulling the enemy's chariot, making it look like a Viman flying in the sky and shining gloriously like the sun. The reflection of Ravana's bow on the chariot surface glistened like a rainbow. Arrows rained from this vehicle like rain pouring from the clouds. Looking at the approaching chariot, Rama pulled at his bowstring, offering a challenge. "Be alert," he said to his driver, Matali, who had been sent by Indra himself. "I intend destroying the enemy's chariot as the winds scattered a mass of clouds. You need not fear and continue to drive steadily. You continue with your job. I want to concentrate on waging the battle." Valmiki continues, "Both the warriors were soon engaged in a bitter fight and faced each other like angry lions hungry to win." Angry lions hungry to win. What an image. For Ravana, the omens were not good. The clouds drenched his chariot in a shower of blood. Hurricanes jolted his vehicle and vultures followed the king's chariot. Lankapuri was tinged in the untimely glow of a sunset as if it was on fire, and meteors streaked down from the sky. The Rakshasa soldiers felt as if their arms had been paralyzed, as if these were restrained by an external force. Rama and Ravana, riding their respective chariots, entered the most decisive phase of the battle. It was cruelly fought, as each one was determined to kill the other. The Rakshasas looked at Ravana taking on Rama as if mesmerized. Nobody raised a finger. The two warriors were left to fight for themselves. Ravana shot a number of powerful arrows at the flag flying on Rama's chariot. However, his arrows failed to reach the flag and fell on the wayside. Rama reciprocated by shooting a sharp arrow, fierce as a cobra and glorious like himself, that cut Ravana's flag before disappearing into the earth. Ravana tried to shoot at Rama's horses, but they went unhurt owing to their divine origin. This disturbed Ravana and he showered Ram with arrows, maces, swords, bolts, rocks, axes, wheels, trees and spears. He was a source of unending, boundless energy. But his arrows could not injure Ram, and this disturbed him. The charioteers of both the warriors displayed remarkable dexterity. They chased each other, went around the other, and advanced and retreated as they thought fit to gain an advantage. At one point, their axles got entangled. At another, the horses faced each other like warriors ready to attack, while the ensigns twisted around each other. I have introduced in this video a painting taken from the British Library. It's a Mewar painting which shows the battle between Ram and Ravana. This painting has many subtexts which can be seen if looked at closely. It shows the fight as well as Ravana as killed by Ram. Ravana, writes Valmiki, had several heads, all adorned with large earrings and golden crowns. Rama sliced one of them with a fiery cobra arrow. The king's severed head fell on the ground, but another one grew in its place instantaneously. This happened many a time, and Rama found it difficult to counter the maya of the Rakshasa Raj. Lot of magic going on. The battle continued from the day into the night without a breath in between. The charioteer Matli reminded Rama to be aggressive. He said, "O warrior prince, why do you rest contented with counter-attack only? His predicted time of death has arrived. Kindly use the Brahmastra against him and kill him." Rama pulled a glorious arrow from his quiver, which hissed like a deadly cobra. Agastya Muni had given this weapon to Ram, making him invincible on the battlefield. Brahma of immeasurable glory had handed it over to Indra for his conquest of the world. The weapon was blessed with the speed of Pavan, the biting edge of Agni and of Surya's heat, the vastness of the sky, the weight of Meru, and the eminence of the Mandarachal mountain. It subsumed within it the glory of all that exists. What words? Remarkable words. Rama chanted empowering mantras in order to invoke the powers of the Brahmastra, pulled the bowstring, mounted the arrow, and fired it at Ravana. Like the invincible Vajra thrown by Indra, and with the finality of a Yamaraja strike, the Brahmastra hit the Rakshasa Raj in his chest and tore his heart apart. Having accomplished its task, the arrow, soaked in the king's blood, passed through his body, rebounded after hitting the ground, and returned to Rama's quiver. Valmiki writes, Ravana fell to the ground with his bow and arrow, lifeless. His soldiers took to their heels, but were chased by the Vanar Sena. While the Vanara's joy knew no bounds, the Rakshas soldiers wept at their defeat. Speedily they retreated into Lankapuri. The Vanara's roared with joy and shouted victorious slogans about Sri Ramchandra. In the heavens, the Devatas rejoiced with the earth having been cleansed of evil. A fragrant mild breeze blew while the Devatas sang Rama's glory. There was rejoicing in every direction. Sugriv, Hanuman, Vibhishan, Angad and Lakshmana expressed joy at Rama's victory. Rama had fulfilled his vow in killing his enemy. The glorious diadem of the Raghu dynasty looked magnificent, like Indra surrounded by the Devatas on the battlefield. Jai Shri Ram, Jai Shri Ram, Jai Shri Ram.